How's everybody doing? How you guys doing? All right, I'm sorry to be having 25 minutes. Wrong crowd. Okay.
And surprisingly, that moment 10 in the front row ran out in seconds.
Oh, it did?
Yeah.
It's kind of, when you start it here, it's kind of not.
Yeah, like you should.
Yeah.
But by the way, congratulations on your Sky Vegas announcement you made the other day on social media.
Yeah, thanks. So there's this company here in right outside of Birmingham. They're called Storm, and they make slot machines, and they make fruit machines. So they contacted me a year ago, and they said, we would like to make a Sean Kelly Storage Auction fruit machine. And I was like, all right, why not? I've done everything else. And so it's up on Sky Vegas now. What's cool about it is that those little locker doors, and then the doors roll up, and then you can bet whether or not you want to see what's in the next door or not.
Oh, that's cool.
I think I've gone on and played the game so many times myself. I think that I've lost more money than they're paying me to actually do it. So I gotta stop actually going on Sky Vegas.
But that must be because I'm a really cool thing for you, because you when you were originally on the content of the storage analytics of like, wow, so years ago now, and then also now you've got Sky Vegas.
Yeah.
It must be kind of like a surreal thing, because you never would have thought at that point in time you had like a fruit machine based on the TV show you know what did.
No, I'll tell you a quick story. In 2009, so many years ago, I used to own a comedy club in San Diego, and I was doing stand-up comedy, and I was doing three jobs. I was doing stand-up comedy at night, during the day I was managing a large newspaper, and on the weekends, for fun, I was doing storage auctions because I just loved doing it. And I was looking for a TV show idea because I thought, oh, if I could get on TV, people will come see me do stand-up comedy. And then one day, it just hit me. I was doing a storage auction, and these two guys got in a fist fight, and they just started beating the hell out of each other. And I was like, wait a minute. This is my show. This is Antiques Roadshow meets WWF. And so my very next auction, I paid a guy to come film it. And then I took that film, and I went to L.A., and I went to every TV station everywhere, and nobody would make the show. They all were like, that's stupid. No one's ever going to watch a show about storage units. I go, no, it's great. It's awesome. You never know what's inside. And finally, after 2 years, I got one place and said, okay, we'll make one pilot and see how well it does. And they made the pilot, and it was the highest rated show in the history of their channel. And they said, okay, we'll make eight more.
Eight.
And then finally, all these years later, I've made 136 episodes, and it airs in 138 countries around the world. And you're right, for me to have this crazy idea, and then I'm just thinking that it's like a fruit machine and all this other stuff, it's really cool.
When did you kind of bring this? Because it's huge here in the UK. It's huge in this country. When did you kind of realize that the Brits have taken such a massive liking to the show?
Oh, you know what? I started getting Facebook requests from the UK, from fans, and people were telling me how much they enjoyed the show. And I didn't even know it was in the UK at the time. And then I got a call from someone, and they asked me if I would come and appear at a Comic-Con. And I didn't understand why. I didn't know what. I had no idea what they were talking about. And they're like, yeah, we'll bring you over. So my wife and I came over, and then while we were here, we went and met with the TV network that airs at Dave. We met with people from Dave, and then when I got to talking to them, and I said, I really like it over here. I should do some auctions here. And they said, let's do it. And that's how I ended up doing the store trying to do
it. It's incredible to think that really.
Yeah.
You spent all that time trying to get the idea made, and then all of a sudden, you got people just fighting with you, throwing on you to make it again. It's incredible.
Yeah. It's unbelievable. The whole experience has been really cool. And, for all, there's a lot of young people in the room today. And here's what I want to tell you about my own personal experience that maybe you can relate to. I was not a very good student in school. I never went to uni. Matter of fact, a lot of people told me I wasn't going to have a very bright future. But what the truth is that if you have a dream, if you have a passion, and if you can see it in your mind, and if you can say, this is what I want to accomplish, if you work hard, and you don't listen to anybody telling you no, if you just focus on it, work hard, you can make your dreams come true. My dreams have come true. This TV show is all, everywhere I travel the world, people know me, and they come up to me, and they go, stuff like that, and it's incredible, and I just, for all the young people here in the room, what I want you to know is that
I agree.
Don't let anybody tell you that you can't do it, because when I first told people that I was going to make a TV show about storage options, all my friends, my family, everyone told me I was crazy.
Is that one?
Who's crazy now?
You've kind of, it must be your sister, and now there are whole days of television devoted to storage hunters.
Yeah, like, everyone, they call it hangover telling. Sunday morning, turn it on and just watch one episode after another.
But for you, then, it's just one of the things that has those open trouble with storage hunters is that loads of people think, right, if they were to do that, what kind of tips could you give them about how to be in the
world?
It's really high risk business. It's really gambling, you know, and it's we only show the best stuff on TV. We only show you, for the most part, people making money and it turning out well. But the truth of the matter is that you can really lose a lot of money. It's really gambling, unless you really know what you're doing, because you can get stuck with a lot of junk. When I do a storage option, I normally do 100 units in one go. I sell one unit every 2 minutes, and it takes me about 3 hours to sell 100 units, roughly. Yeah, maybe a little over 3 hours. On the TV show, we only show you 5, and there's a reason why, because those other 95, not so good. So it's like winning the lottery. I had a guy in California bought a storage unit for me for $125. There was a painting inside the unit. And I didn't know what the painting was. I knew it was probably like a gallery art piece, you know, like it belonged in a museum. We took a picture of it, we sent it to Christie's Auction House in New York. Anyway, long story short, after commission, after taxes, that painting, he made $450,000, and he gave cash for his first house, and he was 23 years old. And that was for a unit that he bought for $125. But I've only seen that happen once, you know? So you can make money, but it's risky.
So we can open the floor up to you, so if you would like to ask a question, you should have a hand on the microphone to you. Please keep your hand up. We'll start with the gentleman here in the middle.
You started in America with the American press, and then you came over to the English press.
Yeah.
If you notice any real difference between the two groups of people?
Well, here's what everybody tells me. They go, hey mate, love the American series, hate the British one. That's what everybody tells me. When I came to the UK to make the British series, for example, what I did was I went out to car boat sales, I went to auctions, and I tried to find bidders that I thought were interesting characters, and then we would invite them to come to the auction. But the problem is that as soon as we turned the TV cameras on, all these people thought this is my chance to become famous, and they just started acting like morons, like this heavy D. I was like, dude, why are you doing that? Because we found Heavy D selling at a car boot sale in North London. And he seemed like an interesting character, and he seemed to know what he was talking about. But on the show, he's just a complete idiot. You know what I mean? And then Natalie and John, they're from Stoke, right? And they own an antique shop in Stoke, and they do house removals, and they sell at the car boot sale. And they're lovely people. And they really know what they're doing. So I like when people are authentic. In America, Brandon and Lori, those guys really make a living buying and selling storage units. They really know what they're doing. Jesse really knows what he's doing. You know, T-Money, God bless him, he doesn't know what he's doing. He still tries to make a living doing it. Papa Bear, you know. But yeah, so, and I think the difference between the way we made the series was, in America, we had a director, and she came from a background where her whole career, she made documentary movies. So she was really good at like letting story unfold, and she was really good at just like letting people go in and explore the units and just finding stuff. The British director was different. He already in his mind, he was thinking about how he was going to edit the show together. He'd be like, just find the most expensive stuff and bring it out and let's talk about it. But I think what that does is it robs the audience from the chance to like the exploration, the discovery, the treasure hunt. That's the part I enjoy. But so they made the show in two different styles because we had two different directors. We had a British director in America. And I kind of like the way we did it in America. But I have to tell you, I've had a great time living in the UK. I've met thousands of awesome bands, so it's been worth my time.
What would be like the best fight?
What's the best one? that we've ever found. Well, I think it was that painting that I told you about. That was probably the most. But, you know, I always like it when we find cool collections, when people have got that crazy collection. Because there's people collect all kinds of weird stuff. And so it's amazing what some people will collect. Like one time we came across a collection of knives. And this guy, like, he must have had, I think it was like 25 or 26,000 knives. And knives from all over the world. And some of them are really cool. One guy was collecting those walking sticks. And some of them are really cool because they're carved. So I like the cool collections. That's kind of fun.
Question you're coming this one?
When you pay for something, when you watch it,
yes.
You have to pay for it, even if you lose it.
Oh, so it's a good question. You're saying, okay, you've seen an episode where someone like paid more than what the unit was worth. Do they still have to pay for it? Yes, they do, my friend. Yes, they do. That's just part of it. So sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. In the real, when we're not filming it for television, I don't let them go straight in. Here's what we do. When we're not filming it for television, what I do is we put a lock on it, lock it back up as soon as I sell it, and we move on to the next one. And then everybody has to come in the office and pay me. I get my money. Then we go back out and take the locks off and put them back inside their storage units. And then they have questions, I go in and I'll say, you know, they're like, hey, Sean, what is this worth or what is that worth? I'll go and answer those questions for them. But with the TV show, we don't have time for that. We just gotta go straight in. But yeah, people end up having to pay if they lose.
I have a question for you. Person A.
What goes through your mind when a fight breaks out to listen to the
other person? Oh, okay, I didn't understand. What goes through my mind when what? The
fight breaks out.
Oh, I love the fights. Yeah, that's what I make the show. I think the fights are up. That's why I'm a security guard. The green mile is so big. I'm not a fighter myself, and I don't like to get hit. But I do enjoy watching people get angry with each other, and I think that's amusing. But we were told by the network back in America that if we had one more fight, they were going to cancel our show. So we had to basically tell people no more fighting. But we would invite people to the auctions that we knew hated each other. Like, you know what I mean? Like Jesse genuinely hates Brandon. And the Rednecks hate Brandon. Like those guys hate Brandon so much that we couldn't show this on TV because we would have gotten sued, but at one point they put Brandon on the hood of a car and they punched him and broke the baby's ribs. I thought it was funny.
Oh,
But luckily it doesn't happen too often. But usually when it does happen, it means there's something illegal inside. It's normally the case. Which, speaking of illegal, this is a true story. Last April, I went home to America and I did a huge auction and a guy bought a storage unit from me. Apparently inside the storage unit was 22 kilos of cocaine. Now, if you call the police right away and give the cocaine back to the police, no problem. But the problem is this guy went on to Google and he said, how does someone sell 22 kilos of cocaine? That guy's in jail now. So, don't be dumb.
Where'd you find the bins from? Who shows you where the bins are?
Oh, the bins! Oh, okay. Well, here in the UK, it's hard. And I'll tell you, it's really hard to find storage facilities that are willing to let you auction off their bins. And the reason why is because the Brits happen to be way more responsible, I found out, than Americans. You guys actually pay your bills. You guys give your debit card, and it bills your debits your debit card every week, and most of you pay your bills on time. Our bills. So it's really easy to find storage units to auction off in America. Matter of fact, when I do an auction in America, it will be normally between 70 and 100 units all in one go. Like one day, boom. Here in the UK, I'm lucky if I can find a facility that has five. And we need a minimum of five to be able to shoot a show. That's why we filmed the Storage Hunters UK all over the UK, because if we could just find it around London, we would have probably just done everything in London because all the film crew is based in London. But it was so hard to find because you guys are really good at paying your bills. So what I like to say is stop being so responsible.
Any question here?
What's the weirdest thing you've ever found in a bin?
The weirdest thing? I would say dead bodies, like crime scenes where people have like murdered someone and disposed of the body. That's weird. That's no good. That's happened twice. One time I opened up a storage unit that a person had been paying on for 12 years, $100 a month for 12 years, and the only thing that they had stored in there, what happened was that person ended up dying, and then they didn't have any relatives that would like keep paying or whatever. We cut the lock, we opened it up, the only thing that was in there was a glass like mayonnaise jar filled with urine. That was it. And this crazy person had paid $100 a month for like 12 years. We're like, who did you
think? For you guys, is there anything you've ever found other than a painting in a storage locker that you've wanted to keep yourself?
Well, I actually had gone and bought at these storage units myself. I've actually bought stuff at my own auction. I'll tell you how that works. In America, because we have so much sunshine, people are so spoiled that whenever it rains, it's hard to get people to come out of their house. Like, you guys would never be able to go anywhere if you stayed at home and it rained. But basically, because it rarely rains in Los Angeles, I did an auction one day in LA, and I was auctioning off about 60 or 70 units, and it was a rainy day, and I only had 10 people show up. I'd only get 400 to 600 people at an auction, and 10 people show up. So, halfway through the auction, those 10 people ran out of money, and so I just went to the owner, and I said, I tell you what, I'll give you $100 for every single one of the rest of the units. So I bought 30 units myself at $100 a go. And I got great stuff. I mean, really cool stuff. Two of the units was a store that had gone out of business that sold nice leather purses. So I got like 600 handbags, all still in the plastic. Someone had collected those Hot Wheels cars. They must have 3,000 or 4,000 of those Hot Wheels. There was loads of good stuff, so I took it all to the car boot sale. And that's when I discovered I didn't want to do it for a living, because I had to go to the car boot like every weekend for like months, and it was driving me crazy. Is anybody selling the car boot sale here? Yeah, you guys sell a car boot? Do you go like often? Oh, 3-4 times. Yeah, that's enough. Yeah, it's a fun way to make a living. Oh, you guys can't hear her. She goes, it's when people jump into the boot of your car before you even have your boss's eyes.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. Get out of my boot!
Alright. Can I say it's a new series called Boot Hunters coming up?
Yeah, that's a good name.
Well,
Room Hunters.
Oh, am I looking to film Sword Hunters anywhere else? No, actually, what I'm working on now is there was this one experience that I had 27 years ago. I'm 46 years old, so when I was 19. When I was 19 years old, I had an experience that was so cool. It made me realize, it was so inspiring and it was so cool. It changed the whole direction of my life, right? And I always wanted to make that into a TV show. And it's an entrepreneur show, and I think you guys will love it. I can't tell you what it is yet, but I went and I pitched the idea to Channel 4, to C4, about a month ago, and they seem to really like it. So fingers crossed, if they make the show, I'll be the presenter on the show, and it's my dream show. It's the show that I wanted to make before Storage Hunters, but I couldn't get anybody interested in it. But now that Storage Hunters has been a success, because everybody said that would be a dumb idea. So now people are listening to this, and I might possibly get it, so let's hope so, because I think you'll really enjoy it.
Now, we've got time for something else I believe you want to do.
Alright. Listen, I figure you can't come see the auctioneer from Storage Hunters without having an auction. You guys want to have a little auction? Yeah, why not? I've been coming to Comic Cons for the last 2 years, and what I do is I go up to the other celebrities and I say, hey, autograph your poster for me, and I thought I'd bring some of them and auction them off.
What's any good there?
I'll start with my own.
So
you have a
genuine, very large poster.
Yeah, so this is from the MCM Comic Con in Birmingham that we did last year, and I autographed the picture. I just thought it'd be kind of a fun way to auction some off. And if you win some, just come up here. Why not? Let's do it. Here we go. Can we turn the lights up just a little bit so I can see some hands? Yeah, I'm going to start to be up here. 1 pound. This is going to give me a pound. I'm going to 1 pound. I'm going to give you 2 pounds. I'm going to give you 3. I'm going to give you 4. I'm going to give you 4. I'm going to give you 5. Here we go, I'm going to start it up in a pound. I'm going to 1 pound bidder. All the money going to help for heroes. 1 pound bidder down to 2, 1 pound bidder down. came to lunch last year as well. Volunteer award, sold for 10 pounds. Give her a big round of applause. This is, oh, hold on. We can take another one.
I'll keep it recording. What if I group that?
Yeah, you know, one hand is an attribute pulse. It's from Primeval and also is currently on his web series Wilds. And that you can find on online.
So you, any Primeval fans here?
Yeah.
So this guy, this, he signed this for us right here. This was from when he was in Scotland, up at MCM Comic Con up in Scotland. And at the end of the show, he autographed it for me. So if you know, any Primeval fans, this is kind of a cool piece. Here we go, 1 pound. How about 1 pound better than 2, 2 pounds better than 3, 4, 4 pounds better than 5, 5 pounds better than 6, 6 pounds better than 7, 6 pounds better than 7 pounds, 7, 7 pounds better than 8 pounds, 7 pounds better than 8, 7 pounds better than 1, 7 pounds better than 1 twice, looking great, 8 pounds better than 9, 8 pounds better than 9, 9, 9, 9, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10,
off. Ready. It's still wouldn't you go there and charge the bike, wouldn't you? What, your £1 cheaper than you would have paid for one?
Yeah.
Go on, when you would have paid 15 quid for one? Counting his money out, huh? What? He don't get that money, does he? I don't know how that would work, you don't pay him, you don't get it, does he? You don't want to come here for nothing, would he? Well, probably some people probably would want to. They don't mind us. It's a fair time for them, innit? So come here for free, right? Getting paid for airtime. Advertising myself.